So here we are at West Coast Cylinder Head, watching the L92 heads get ported. Check out all this code that it's running by. I mean, this is insane. This is all the code it needs just for some of the movement of the porting process. Totally insane. Beats the hell out of doing it by hand. Many years I spent doing it by hand. That finished the logo?
Yeah.
Let's see what that looks like. So this is Rich putting his signature mark on the head here. West Coast Racing Cylinder Heads.
I think I have the other style ones. 823 and 821 are the common LS3 and L92 heads, you know, casting. So, but this one here is, these have a little bigger cast finish ports, the 5364,
okay,
by about 3 or 4 cc's. Basically, as I was explaining to you earlier, before we put the heads in the fixture, we do a light deburring around a valve cover rail and some of the major edges and such, because out of the box they're really, really sharp cylinder heads. So knocking the edges down makes them easy to handle. We don't get so many cuts and abrasions while we're working with them.
Yeah, I can definitely say from working with the LS heads, those things are like razors.
Yeah, all of them are just traditionally super sharp. And we're going to go ahead and logo this one again.
So this is Richard from West Coast Cylinder Head. This is what I consider a solid gold guy. We've known each other for, I don't know, shit, it's going on 15 years now, you know?
Scary thought.
And we've done Engine Masters competitions together. And if there's ever a guy I'm going to trust with my cylinder heads, this is the guy. I mean, he is just an incredible cylinder head man. And when it came to me choosing a guy to port our heads for our turbo combinations and our naturally aspirated combinations on the new LS motors, he's pretty much the ultimate, was what I would consider. So I'll let Richard go from there.
Thank you, Tom. I appreciate the kind words. This is our Fidel CNC machining center that we built our own 5-axis cylinder head fixture on. Basically, we can position or articulate the cylinder head in a multitude of different ways of approaching a way of reaching ports and combustion chambers for the machining process. In a nutshell, we have 5 ranges of motion or 5 axes of motion, left and right, which is our X direction. forward and backward, which is our Y direction. We can move our spindle column up and down, which is our Z motion direction. We have one rotary motion here, our A axis, which rotates 360 degrees like a barrel. And then we can articulate in the B axis, which will give us our tip or teeter. And that lets us get around the pushrod bends and around some corners that you might not otherwise do with a four axis machine. And what we're getting ready to do is we're going to run our stage 2 CNC port program on the cell 92 or LS3 casting. We do a program that machine finishes the combustion chambers, does a partial intake port in the bowl area, a partial intake from the gasket entrance side. We machine along the entire floor of the intake port, and then we machine the exhaust port complete from the seat to the gasket flange. And basically, we're good for improving airflow on the intake side. We take it up from about 325 CFM to a little over 350 CFM in the usable lift curve. Airflow peaks out at about 640 to 650 lift. The exhaust port, there's a dramatic increase in airflow. We take them from about 205 CFM out to about 250 CFM. And that is a pretty healthy pickup over the factory port. We also don't remove a lot of material with this because these heads have such large cast finished ports to start with. So shape is everything. They already have lots of cross-sectional area, which is good for high flow volumes. They already have fairly large valve sizes in them, so we really just need to make sure that the detail work is what's covered, and that's what this program serves to do.
Check out this fixture that Richard, this is what I've got wood on, taking a look. Richard basically programmed and machined this fixture in this machine. It's one of the nicest ones I've seen. It's just a gnarly fixture. I mean, years and years ago when he started with this, I mean, the amount of learning that he's had to do to, you know, for years, all I did was port heads, and I'd always be picking Richard's brain about how do you port this, how do you port that, and he was the master. And you know, now he's into the CNC world, and it's just an awesome thing for me to see. And his fixture's bitching, and it's just a real cool marriage of ideas.
Thanks, Tom. We'll go ahead and send the fixture to home and pull up the stage 2 program and let her rip. Excuse me one second. Close it here and you might see a little bit of flash going on.
Cutting the combustion chamber. One real advantage of the CNC ported is that how every port is equal. So your consistency is just, you know, it's just all the same, and that's super important when you start making big power. So every intake port, every exhaust port, every combustion chamber, it's all gonna be the same. All the volumes will be the same. Like I said before, it sure beats the hell out of doing it by hand. I mean, doing it by hand definitely has its place, but that's what Richard's done here. Is he's basically spent hours and hours and hours porting by hand and figuring out what the best port is for what we're trying to do, and then made a program for it. And then it's always the same. It's just bits.